All right, we're going to do some more problems dealing with parallel and perpendicular lines. So here's an example where we're going to put what we know about parallel lines and how to write equations of lines. Write the equation of a line parallel to the line y equals 2x minus 4 and passing through negative 6, negative 1. Now, first of all, notice that negative 6, negative 1 is not on the line y equals 2x minus 4. So it's on a line parallel to that, for instance. So if we want to get a little picture of what is going on here, we're saying, well, 2x minus 4, let's say that is negative 4. We're just doing a little rough estimate here. 2x minus 4, the y-intercept here is 0, negative 4. And if these are also going up by 2s. So if I have a slope of 2, I'm going over, 1 and up 2, for instance. I have something like this for my original line, but I'm trying to find the equation of the line that's parallel to this line and going through the point negative 6, negative 1. So for instance, negative 6, negative 1 is maybe right about here. So I'm looking for this line that's parallel. So it's good to have a little picture in your mind what it is you're trying to do. Now how are we going to do this? Well, so we wanted the equation of the line parallel to the line y equals 2x minus 4. Well, if it's parallel, it's got to have the same slope. So what's the slope of the line y equals 2x minus 4? It's 2. And what's the point it goes through? One of the points is negative 6, negative 1. And let's just use the slope point formula. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. And what are we going to do? We're going to plug in 2 for the slope. For y1, I want my y-coordinate, negative 1. And for x1, I want my x-coordinate, which is negative 6. So I'm going to put in y minus negative 1, which will be y plus 1. Slope is 2. X minus a negative 6, that'll end up being an x plus 6. If we solve for y, we'll have it. So if I solve for y, I'm going to put that negative 1 on the other side, subtract 1 from both sides, and I'm going to do the distributive property. 2x plus 12 minus 1. So what do we get? Y equals 2x plus 11. That looks like it's the equation. Now let's look over at our picture. Does it look like that's going to go through at the y-intercept of 11? Well, that seems reasonable. Here's 4, 6, 8, 10. I'm kind of rough, it was a rough estimate, not a very perfect graph, but that looks like that will be correct. You would want to make sure that when you plug in negative 6, negative 1 into this equation, it absolutely is an ordered pair on this line, which it is. And it still has a slope of 2. So everything looks good. I'm going to change this problem slightly. Write the equation of the line perpendicular to the line y equals 2x minus 4 and passing through negative 6, negative 1. So instead of parallel, now I'm saying, what if we want the line that is perpendicular? Oops, did you hear my phone ring? Okay, I'm back. All right, write the equation line perpendicular to the line y equals 2x minus 4. The picture is the same where I did a little rough sketch here, 2x minus 4, a line like this. That was the original line. And then we're going to look for a line going through negative 6, negative 1. But you know what? This time we want our line to be perpendicular. So I'm not sure exactly where it's going to be, but something like that. Okay, we're going to look for a perpendicular line. So I can see that my slope is going to be negative. All right, so if it's going to be perpendicular to the line y equals 2x minus 4, since that slope has 2, the perpendicular slope that we're going to be dealing with will be negative the reciprocal of 2. So it's negative 1 half. All right, so I've got to write the equation of a line where the slope is negative 1 half, right? And it's going through the point negative 6, negative 1. And let's go ahead and use the point slope formula again. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. All right, what are we doing here? We're going to put in negative 1 half for the slope, right? We're going to put in negative 6 for my x coordinate, my x1, and I'm going to put in negative 1 for my, that's my y coordinate, so that's going to be my y1. So we have y minus negative 1, which is y plus 1, equals negative 1 half. X minus negative 6 is x plus 6. All right, so we're going to solve for y. I'm going to distribute my negative 1 half, so negative 1 half x minus 3, because that's negative 1 half times 6 is a negative 3, and I've also got to subtract 1 from both sides. So my answer is negative 1 half x minus 4. All right, look at my picture over here. Actually, I didn't do a very good job of doing a perpendicular line because it looks like it's going to go through negative 4 right here. So I guess I didn't draw that very accurately. The actual perpendicular line is something like this. Doesn't look perpendicular, does it? But of course, I didn't draw a very accurate graph. So let's see. Does negative 6, negative 1, is that a point on this line? If I put in negative 6, I get 3 minus 4 is negative 1. Yes, so that's on this line, and it does have a slope of negative 1 half. So if I would have got it out graph paper and done this, it would have been better, obviously. Probably because of this order pair right here I didn't have in the right place. So the answer to this problem is y equals negative 1 half x minus 4. There we go. Hope you can see it. And there it is. Here are three problems that should be quick and easy for you to do. See if you could do those. Write the equation of the line passing through 0, negative 6. Hint, I'm giving you the y-intercept. If its slope is 5, write that equation. Then try it. If the line's parallel to the line y equals 4x plus 3, and then let's also do it for a line that's perpendicular to the line y equals 2 thirds x minus 7. So see if you could write the equation of the line, all having, going through this order pair, 0, negative 6, and then with these three different conditions. All right, the first one, slope's 5, that's easy. Y equals 5x, and b is negative 6, so y equals 5x minus 6. Number two, the line is parallel to y equals 4x plus 3. Well, then it's got the same slope as this line, doesn't it? So it's got 4x, and again, minus 6, because they all have a y-intercept of negative 6. And if it's perpendicular to y equals 2 thirds x minus 7, all right, this slope is 2 thirds, so the line perpendicular will be negative 2 thirds. That's the slope of that line, and also minus 6. So, how'd you do? Hope you got those correct. And just all sorts of different questions you could be asked about parallel and perpendicular lines. Here are a few problems for you to try. Determine whether the lines are parallel, perpendicular, or neither for each set of two lines. So for number one, y equals 3x minus 4. Well, the first line has a slope of 3. I put it in slope-intercept form. The second line is not in slope-intercept form. If you put it in slope-intercept form, if you solve for y, you'll get y equals 3x minus 8. So you know what? It also has a slope of 3. What happens if the slopes are the same? They're parallel. Okay, let's go on to the second one. I put it in slope-intercept form, so the slope of the first line is 2 thirds, and the slope of the second line is 3 halves. Are they the same? No. So they're not parallel. Is one negative reciprocal of the other? No. They're reciprocals, but they don't have different signs. So this is neither parallel nor perpendicular. And the last one, I put it in slope-intercept form to make it easy. The first has a slope of 2, second a slope of negative 1 half. Is one, are they the same? No. Is one negative the reciprocal of the other? Yes. So yay, these are perpendicular. All right. That's all there is to it.